Hey everyone. In this video today, I'm going to show you how to set up Zapier and HubSpot so that you can use Google Sheets to schedule all of your social media posts and then publish them in HubSpot without having to click around and do any of the manual setup. So we'll jump straight in. In HubSpot, you can go to social by going to marketing and then social media, and then it pops up here. And what we're going to do is we're going to use this Google Sheet that I've started to work on here with a social media schedule, so that when we update this sheet, it'll automatically, using Zapier, add a post into the schedule in HubSpot. So it's pretty simple. We've got this sheet here, which has columns for each of the things to help organize the posts. We've got the channel just to keep track, which channel we're posting on, the content that's going to go into the Zap and into the post, the time we want to schedule it, and then a little trigger here so that we can work on this without automatically triggering the Zap each time. So essentially, we start by going into Zapier, and then we're going to type in to what we want to automate using the little AI feature here. And I've added in to update a row in Google Sheets and then publish this social media on HubSpot. So we click next, and then we have this here, new row, create social media. So we click try that, and then we select our account in Google. I've previously connected this up, click continue. We select our spreadsheet. We select our worksheet, and then importantly, we're going to set it so that it only triggers when a column gets changed. And in this case, we're going to use this column here, which is the status column. So this is why we have this here. We're going to set it so that whenever this column gets changed, it's going to trigger the Zap. So we need to be careful with this column, and we're only going to use this. Basically, I've just got one choice here. So when this gets clicked to publish, it's going to then trigger the Zap. So I'm going to change this to status. Click continue, test the trigger, and then we can see here our first one HubSpot has launched has appeared. There it is. So we're going to use this as our trigger, continue. Okay, and then for HubSpot, we're going to use this create social media message as our event. We select our HubSpot account, click continue. We select our social media channel. So we're going to use LinkedIn to start with for this example. And then the message content is going to come from that row. So we've got our content column. We add that in here, and then the time we want to schedule it, we're going to put that here. So we want to have a date and a time. So we're doing this on the 12th at 11:10 a.m. And then we can select here if we want to save it as a draft or if we want to just schedule it. So I'm going to leave this blank, but you could make it true if you wanted to keep these all as drafts and then sort of double check them in HubSpot. We click continue. If you don't add a time here, it will automatically publish whenever anyone updates this column. So you want to make sure you add a time and a date here, just so that you can control when the posts are being published and you don't publish all of your posts in one go. So be careful here. This date field is pretty generous. You can format it in different ways. So just keep this in mind that you've got to be a bit careful with US, UK style dates and times. But so it's always important to test before as you're working on this. In this case, I have all my accounts set to sort of UK, Australia time style. So this should be fine for me. Click continue. And then we can test the step. So we'll go into HubSpot. And then in HubSpot, it should appear under this scheduled section here. Cool. So we've got our post here, ready to go. So now let's turn on the Zap and let's test it for real. So we click publish. Okay. Now we can do this for the second social media post. So I've got this one scheduled for the 19th, and now I can click publish. And then let's go into Zapier and let's just check on the Zap runs and we'll see when this goes through. I'm just going to update this to the last 24 hours. Okay, and now we can see that it's playing. Let's have a look. It looks like it's gone through. Let's have a look in HubSpot. Okay, and now we can see that it's updated in HubSpot, and we can see the 19th of March. Interestingly, it's updated to 12:20 p.m. And so I think that might be something to do with the time zone difference. Let's take a look. So in HubSpot, we can check the time zone that the Zap is set for by going to the details section. We can see the time zone is set to Melbourne, and I'm currently in Hong Kong. So let's change this to Hong Kong. And let's see if this will fix that time zone issue. I'm going to add this again as another row, so that it gets reset. And we'll change this to published. And then let's go in and have another look at the zap run. Okay, took about a minute or so, but we've got our second zap that's playing. Let's check out the social again, refresh. Great, so we've got 19th of March, this one here, 3:20 p.m. Excellent, so this has worked. So we can delete this one here. And then the other ones will be scheduled for the times we've set. So now this is set up. If we add any more posts into here, then it will automatically then keep scheduling it in HubSpot like this. And these will be published when they're ready to go. So it's pretty simple. Let me know if you have any troubles with that. And if you have any questions and I'd love to help out, please feel free to add them in the comments. And if this has been useful for you, like the video, subscribe to get more content like this about HubSpot and Zapier and other software and digital tools. And look forward to seeing you in the next video. Okay, cheers, bye.